You're a prolific author. You write for the beginner readers, then you write for tweenies, but you also write for young adults. You aim at the slightly younger young adults. Please tell us how you do the three different versions of your work.
Isaac, yes, thanks for the question. I think it's a very interesting one. And the answer is difficult for me because it's something that comes rather naturally to me. I think the answer lies in the characters that you create. Usually in children's books, in when you're writing for beginner readers, the characters and the readers are more or less the same age. So if you're writing for 7 year olds, your characters are going to be 7 years old. And that's more or less the answer that I want to give you. When I'm writing for 7 years old, for kids who are 7 years old, I write about 7 years, kids who are 7 years old. So when you climb into that character's head, that is when you start creating for that that age group. And when I'm writing for young adults, it's the same thing. I'm writing about kids who are 14 or 15 years old, and the characters are 14 and 15 years old. So that's the easy part. You start thinking back about to how things were when you were 14 or 15 years old. You think about the teens that you know nowadays who are 14 or 15 years old. My own kids are approaching that age at the moment. So it's not really climbing into the heads of the target market as such, as rather climbing into the heads of your characters. And that's the part of writing that I really enjoy. The best thing about writing is climbing into, getting into the head of a character and starting to understand them and starting to understand what motivates them. And the moment you do that, it's not really that difficult writing for different target markets because everything is character driven. So I think that's more or less the most important thing that you have to understand when you are writing for different markets. And people often ask me, how do you get into the head of a 14-year-old or a 7-year-old or a 12-year-old? And I think there's something a bit demeaning about that question. Kids aren't aliens. They are people, after all. They're people just like adults are. They have the same kind of thoughts. Their world's a little different. They experience things in different ways, but it's not as if you're writing for a totally foreign market. Every one of us used to be kids. I remember my own childhood days very vividly. So the only thing you do is you travel back a bit to the times when you were younger. And then you write about human experiences. As I've said, you're not writing about aliens.